The last thing we have to fill out on our income statement is this column over here that says percentage of sales. And it is something called a component percentage. So in this case, the component I'm looking at is sales because it's a sales, but you could have advertising expense component, but we're gonna look at the sales component for our income statement. And what that is taking a look at the percentage of the actual financial statement and the total and comparing those two. So if I'm finding the percent of sales component percentage for a revenue account, what I'm doing is I'm taking my total sales number and I'm dividing it by whatever the component percentage I'm trying to find is. So I'm trying to find the percentage of sales. So I'm taking sales divided by sales. So if I took my total sales, which if I look at my totals column, I have got 3,565. And I divided it by whatever the component percentage I'm trying to find is. Again, I'm trying to find sales, so I'm gonna divide it by the total sales. I'm dividing it by 3,565. I hit equals, I get 1. I have to change this into a percentage because it says percentage of sales. So I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna multiply it by 100 because 100 is the highest percent I can get on a test. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to write down 100.0. I'm always going to round to that 100th place. The next thing I want to look down is the next total that I have. So the next total I have is total expenses. So I'm going to take my total expenses and again, divide it by whatever the component percentage I'm trying to find. I'm trying to find the percentage of sales. So I'm going to divide it by my sales number. So what I would do mathematically here is I take my total expenses, 1,466, I divide it by my total sales, 3,565, and I get 0.41122 blah, blah, blah. I have to change this into a percentage. So multiply it by 100, and I get 41.1. I'm always gonna round to that nearest 100th. So if I go back over here, I'm gonna write in 41.1 next to my total expenses. When I look at either my net income or my net loss, I would take that total of whatever's in that net column and divide it by the component percentage, so percentage of sales. If I went over to my calculator, I would be taking the total net, which is 2,099, dividing it by the total sales, 3,565. And I have, again, a decimal that I need to convert into a percentage because it's a component percentage, so times 100. I get 58 point, and now I need to round because I have 87, so I'm going to round this up to 0.9. So 58.9. Now a way for you to double check this is whatever percentage that you're finding, so in this case, I'm finding the percentage of sales should be 100%. If I was finding the percentage of expenses would be 100%. Whichever two you're not finding, so in this case, I'm not finding total expenses percentage. I'm not finding the net income percentage. I would take those two and together they should add up to 100. So in this case, if I looked at my expense percentage of 41.1 and my net income percentage of 58.9, those should equal the 100% that I have of sales. So if I took 41.1 plus 58.9, I do get 100. And that is what a full income statement will look like. We've got our heading, we've got all our accounts and our amounts, and then we've filled out our component percentage column. Here is an income statement that actually has multiple sources of revenue and a net loss. So before we were only dealing with one type of sales, so we got to dump it into the totals column right away. In this case, there are two types of sales. So it looks exactly how we did our expenses before. We listed the individual types of sales, and then we had the separate total revenue line, and the total got dumped in the total column on the right. Expenses looks exactly the same as how we were doing it. Again, with a net loss, we still put the total amount in the right total column, but anytime it's a loss or a negative number, we put it in parentheses. So you're gonna see the component percentage would also be negative, because you would have to take 123.7 minus 23.7, and that would equal out to get your 100%.